When you say, I want to give a sacrifice today, you go beyond that amount. The Bible talks about Jesus. When he was sitting in the place where they were giving offering, as he was busy washing there, the Bible says, and then a widow came. She came and she gave. She gave a coin. And when she went to sit, and Jesus stood up, he says, out of everyone who was coming to give here, the woman who has given this amount is the one who has given more than everyone. But when you look at what the woman gave, according to some people, it was just a change. Jesus was not looking at the amount. He was looking at where the money is coming from. He was looking at the situation, the circumstances that surround that type of the amount. Because that woman, she gave everything that she was having. It was the best that she was having into her own hands. Inside her pocket and in the bank account, that's what she was having. She turned to God. It was not a normal offering. It was a sacrifice. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, before we go further, I want us to go to the Word of God. We are reading from the book of Genesis tonight. Hallelujah. If you came with your Bible, let's go to the book of Genesis. Somebody read for me. As we are going to read the Bible from the book of Genesis chapter 8, verse 19, 20, and 21. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Is there anyone who is there? Casper, I see my sister, she's having it there. Read it for us. Because you read it again on Tuesday, I think. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Read it.
Genesis 8, from verse 19 to 22.
Yes. Come on now.
Verse 19. Didi pa palo kamuka, didi rarabi kamuka, didi nonyana kamuka, linyama nyama kamuka ya mole fasi. Kamuka cha cha mo pulukelo ndi ya kami kuta ya chona. Verse 20. Nuare agala murena alitare ancha chedi mwa udi rui wakamuka chedi sailiru le udi nonyana kamuka chedi sailiru ajira setabelo mo alitare. Verse 21. Murena anatifalo akimungo omubusi mo pilu nyanga we ari ngasike ka buela ka roba lefase ka baka la motho gobane diakanyo tsa pelo ya motho e le tse mpe go tloga janeng ya gagwe. Nka seke ka buela ka dira se ke se dirilego ga ke bolaya tsotlhe tsa diphelago. 22. Bjale le metleng yotlhe ya lefase go ka seke go atlwa go kgaotsa go bjala le go buna le maruru le go fisa le letlabula le marega le bošego le mosegare.
Halleluja. Halleluja.
Amen.
The Bible here,
Bibelimo,
I wonder, after I talk what I'm talking,
and then
you compare with the prayers that you pray, and the way these legends in the Bible have been doing things, I want you to compare so that you can see which one that produces the results. I know prayer produces results, and the sacrifice also produces the results. But I want you to which one produces better results? So the Bible says, because there was a lot of sin into this world. When you read from Genesis chapter 6, sin entered into the world. God was not happy over what was sin. And then he decided to wipe everyone into this world. And he spoke to Noah. This was Noah. I want you to prepare the ark. Because I am going to bring the rain. Noah began to build that ark for 120 years. As he was busy putting, some people were busy laughing at him. Because you must understand, in this world, before Noah, there was no rain in this world. So when you tell somebody to say rain is going to come, they have never seen it. They cannot believe you. Just like the world, when we tell people, to say the world is going to come, to say the world is going to finish, people, they are not believing. Because you have never seen it.
When I think about
some people were busy arguing,
but you never had it.
You said the rain will never come.
I
we have never seen the rain.
I think about
so what you are saying, you are a mad person.
But you don't know Noah.
But Noah continued to do that.
Noah
until when the time came,
then
the
great fit.
Noah entered into the boat.
Noah again was
all the people, the family of Noah also entered there. When they entered there, and they made the animals also to enter there, and the rain came. When the rain came, everyone was killed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now when everything was settled, the Bible says that Noah and his people came out. When they came out there, he saw how people died. How animals die. Things were destroyed by the rain.
No one
realized something.
No, I am a sister.
So this thing, it is the grace of God.
I didn't take it over one
day. Me and my family, we can be alive.
But
I supposed to do something for God.
When
some of us in this church, God
has
been doing something for us in our lives. But we have never thought of doing something great for God.
We
think it is just natural. We have never thought of sacrificing for God. But when Noah saw what he passed through, when he saw the hand of God, he says, I cannot keep quiet. I must be able to say thank you to my God. And the way I am saying thank you, it is not only from my mouth. I must do something tangible to show that I am grateful for what God has done. Some of you were sick. Some sickness that you had. Because of what God has done. something that you build so that you and the spirit you can go and meet there.
The red pole.
about to bring rain.
Years from now,
you
will never
to want. And God will give you what you need.
Some time back.
This is a trick we are waiting on.
These people were fighting because Elijah was serving a bigger God.
But Elijah ran a little bit of room.
But he chose a prayer. She says, my God is bigger.
Jezebel had a mutima
wakem
room.
Until Elijah one day said, no man.
Elijah,
we cannot be fighting.
Let your
God. And my God, let us come and show their own power.
But how
are they going to show their power?
So
by building their own altars. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says they build the altars. The altar for God here.
Altar
and the altar for Baal was that on the side.
Altar
and
Baal is side.
Elijah was alone.
Elijah
was alone. He was alone. One prophet.
And
for about 400 prophets.
Prophet 400.
Hallelujah. If your neighbor is praying for us, shock them and say fire.
Fire.
As if your neighbor is seeing vision.
Fire.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am saying wake them up and shout fire.
But we say
hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Tell them so you must wake up.
Okay.
Because if you don't know what is happening,
but
hallelujah. I hope I'm within time. Hallelujah. It's like Nagoyaka is finishing before I finish. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But anyway, let me talk about this thing. The Bible says, they says we cannot be fighting like this.
But we can see, look at it like.
So we are going to do something. They brought the 400 prophets of God.
But
they
brought
their own altar. Hallelujah. And also Elijah did his own altar on the other side.
Elijah
did
his own altar.
So today, we are going to see who is God in Israel. And they say we are going to build this altar.
They built
the altar there. And the people of Baal, they killed the cow.
They put
it on altar there. And they says we are not going to use the matches. We are not going to use the
matches.
If your God is hungry, he's coming with his own matches. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He will come with his own fire.
To
come and burn this.
And that
so that he can eat. And the Bible says, the prophet of God were there. They began to cry to their God. Your lunch is saved. Your lunch is saved. Come and eat now here.
We
shut the matches on the pray your matches.
We shut the matches if you like the Lord.
Their God was not there. They shouted, he was not listening. No, shout more.
No, well and come on.
Your God went to the toilet. Call him, he must come. Say, come and eat. Their God was not answering.
So
that he went to sleep. Shout is going to wake up. He did not listen. From morning until evening. They started cutting themselves. Still, nothing happened. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know why that God was not coming? When there is two altars, when there is a real God, the fake God did not show up. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Just like when you have the traditional Coca-Cola, hallelujah.
Cold drink and drink.
Hallelujah.
Original.
A fake one cannot show up there. Hallelujah. Because the original is there.
Original.
It is not that their God was there. No. The God of power was there. Power was there. But he cannot show up. The true God is there. He was afraid. And now when it was time for Elijah to come, he said, put some 4-7 packets of water there. He said, my God, if you want to eat, even in the water you can enter.
water.
He can put fire in the water there.